Whenever we hear about world wars, we hear about weapons. Bioweapons is one such weapon. One of the biophysicians, Bloch, basically said that bioweapons are poor man's atom bomb. That means they are very, very low cost and they are highly destructive in nature. So if we want to classify the weapons of mass destruction, we can say they could be nuclear weapons, they could be radiological weapons, there could be chemical weapons that are there, and of course what we are discussing today, the biological weapons. Now if we classify these bioweapons, what could those be? They could be in the form of viruses, they could be in the form of bacteria, they could be in the form of fungi, they could be in the form of any toxins that are released. Most commonly heard about stories, if we look on to our past, have related bioweapons to diseases like anthrax, diseases like smallpox, diseases like plague. We would talk about the history of bioweapons in a while and how they had been used ruthlessly in the past. If we talk about bioterrorism, we can say bioterrorism could turn into an epidemic if we have diseases like Lassa fever, which is hemorrhagic in nature. We can have diseases like Ebola, which could be future biological weapons that could be there. So bioweapons can be classified into three categories, category A, B and C. Now what's the difference? Category A is a category which talks about highest priority. Those are those disease agents that are highly detrimental to the national security and can be immediately transmitted from one person to another person, have a very high rate of mortality and can lead to social disruption. Common examples of the bioweapons that could fall in category A are anthrax, plague, smallpox, as we mentioned. Then we also have Ebola, Lassa and other hemorrhagic fevers, viruses that could lead to other hemorrhagic fevers. Category B is a category which is moderate and results in lesser mortality as compared to category A. For example, Q fever, Rinsen toxin, typhus fever are some of the examples for the same. And they are considered as emerging diseases. So they are not presently there, but they are emerging in nature. Category C is a very risky category, we could say, because these are the bioweapons that could be genetically created. They can be genetically engineered, genetically modified. Common examples would be Nipah virus, Hanta virus. Then we have major hemorrhagic fever causing diseases and multi-drug resistant bacteria that could be very, very detrimental in nature and could be genetically engineered. So those are the three categories of bioweapons that we talk about. Now if we talk about the bioterror threat, what it is, if these microorganisms, be it virus, bacteria, fungi, they are being intentionally used and they are being engineered to harm the civilization and create social disruptions or lead to a disruption or in the civilian life or the life of the common man, they are considered as bioterror threats. If we focus on to the past history, our history has been very astonishing. In 1155, there was the Emperor Barbarossa who poisoned the water wells with the human bodies in Italy. Similarly, in 1336, the Mongol attackers from the present-day Ukraine region basically used catapults to create the bodies of those who had died in the bubonic plague over the city walls of Kaffa. Similarly, there were Tunisian forces which were using clothes which were tainted with plague as a weapon to seize La Cise. Similarly, there were plans where intentional use was made by Britishers to transmit smallpox to the Native Americans in America. We do not know how successful the event was, but we do not know about the execution, but yes, we do know that the native people were badly affected by smallpox and it was one of the terror nights that were created in the regions of America. The next was a similar example by Napoleon. Napoleon did a very simple experiment. He just flooded the regions around Italy, and the idea was to spread malaria. The next was the use of plague, cholera, and shigella as the biological weapons by Japan on two major cities of China during the period of 1930s to 1940s, where the Sino-Japanese war was there. And it is believed that nearly 5.8 lakh Chinese died as a result of it. So during this time, what happened was there was a momentum on biological weapons and manufacturing of that. So America started to manufacture biological weapons. However, in 1969, the program was ended in America. And in 1975, there was BWC, the Biological Weapon Convention. And nearly 100 nations ratified this convention and said that they would ban one and all types of biological weapons. Former Soviet Union was stockpiling a lot of smallpox virus, and it was an accidental release which was heard in 1979 when Serdivlovsky, one of the major sites in Russia where this smallpox virus was being manufactured, leaked, and this accidental release of the anthrax spores killed lot of the animal life and affected lot of human beings in the region close to the site in Russia. Later on, we still do not have good experts, we could say, are still skeptical about the fact that all the things have been destroyed as biological weapons there because all the records have no more been seen there. Similarly, in 1991, during the Gulf War period, we have seen that Iran had a stock of anthrax, and that was a lot of controversial issue as a biological weapon during that time. Also, in 1995, very recently, we have seen sarin gas that was leaked in the Tokyo region. That was mainly by one of the cult in Japan, which was known as the Om Shrikyo. And that cult basically tried to spread the sarin gas in the nearby areas. So the history has got to speak about biological weapons indeed. But what has been the preparation from the various nations so far? Before the 9/11 attack on the Trade Towers in America, it was a codenamed project which was known as Dark Winter. The idea was that if smallpox as a virus could be released in the population, how could the government actually help curtail it? So this operation was made when nearly 12 million doses of smallpox vaccine were available immediately with America. But still, there were numerous weaknesses that were cited. First weakness that was cited was how this the fact was that despite that there was vaccine, how the vaccine delivery could be streamlined across the nation. The second important issue that was addressed was the center and the state did not have proper coordination in terms of providing the vaccination and managing the resources. The third important issue was that there was a severe shortage of the medical infrastructure that was required for this dummy project that was created. And the fourth important issue that was seen was the trust in the common man on the systems. So those were some of the issues that were highlighted. And of course, when it comes to the present time, not related to the biological weapons, but despite of that, when we are talking about vaccinating and vaccinating the people, these are the issues that come back again. So history repeats itself, no doubt. However, there have been events where we have been talking about the preparation strategy, how sound it should be. So when it comes to smallpox vaccine, the idea was that one who has been in the first line of contact with any person who has had a smallpox virus PPE was mandatory for 4 days, and that was one of the most effective first line of defense that was called as. Later on, it was believed that vaccination should start from the first day itself, and also passive immunization was very, very important. If we talk about the case study of anthrax, it is again very, very interesting. Anthrax, the spores can remain there for more than 100 years. Only in adequate presence of sunlight, anthrax spores can die. However, they are extremely lethal spores and can lead to inhalation anthrax as well, because if those spores only are inhaled, that can create the disease at its extreme fatal proportion. So anthrax had been a major disease that had been talked about. Now, if we talk about the First World War, Second World War, we have witnessed cases where anthrax was used as a biological weapon. Similarly, during the Second World War, we have also witnessed food poisoning, cholera, glanders as some of the common diseases that were used as biological weapons, or some of the common things that were used as biological weapons during that time. So this was a very basic introduction about biological weapons. In the next class, we would be talking about Biological Weapons Convention, what was it and how the nation signed and ratified it. Stay tuned for updates from our side. Have a wonderful day ahead.